Welcome back, everybody, to your coverage of the International 3 group stages. I am Tobi One.
And I am Wagamama.
And we are here, man, for what match?
I'm actually just looking
How
at the draft.
How could you not know, man?
I'm looking at the draft.
Okay, that's fair
it's
enough.
Fucking awesome.
I can understand that one. Yeah. Na'Vi versus Mouse, man. Yeah. Na'Vi versus
How excited are you for this game?
I'm actually really excited for this game because, obviously, Na'Vi fanboy at heart. But also, I'm such great friends with the Mousesports guys, and I wish Cinderin all the best here. I think we're going to have ourselves a fun game. I think we're going to have ourselves a long game.
But so the match history kind of doesn't look good for your favorite Dane there.
No, it doesn't, actually. Let me just switch over quickly to what's been happening so far in the group stages. So the international group stages so far, you can see the entire list up, and Mousesports, obviously, like, things haven't been going too well. He got 1-1. We cast him before with that one. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, it's better than Na'Vi's result right now.
Yeah, Na'Vi, of course, being 0-2'd by Fnatic. So that's something they have to deal with now. And I think Na'Vi doesn't really want to lose against Mouse now, too, because then they would be in a very, very weird spot that no one pretty much expected.
Yeah. It's like, let's actually quickly, before the draft keeps going, because guys, right now, like, we'll get to the draft. Let's actually look through the lineup. So we've got the entire lineup. Just so you know, 15 matchup. These guys are face up against each other 15 times. The win ratio gets to go to Na'Vi, 9-3.
That's not 15 times.
No, it's the ratio.
Oh, the win ratio.
Ba-da-ba-ba-me?
Yes.
Yeah. So it does go to Na'Vi, of course. The latest time, the biggest time you probably would remember is the D2L Finals live on stage when Na'Vi crushed Mousesports 3-0. The third game was a little bit closer than the first two,
but Tobi,
it's still how it all ended up, man.
Why not just say that the win ratio is 1-3?
But that's I don't know. I didn't make the system. All I said was I wanted a ratio of the matchups. And they're like, you know what? Hashtag production value. More numbers equal better.
Okay. Okay, Tobi.
Why do you argue non-logic?
Okay. Do you want to head into a game?
Yeah. The game is good, man. The game is good. All right. So let's check out what's happening up with that draft. So we'll run through. What do we got? Mousesports taking out the Chen. Sorry, respect Band of Puppy. Wisp also finding his way into that Band pool. And then Batrider as well as the Nyx Assassin. So Batrider and Wisp both get out. Lifesteal being removed out. We already saw Mousesports pick that up earlier today. So remove it. And again, we get the Visage pickup. Surprise, surprise. And a first pick OD Alchemist. And OD gets in.
That's the first time we see OD today.
Yeah,
on
actually,
our stream at least.
I think actually we're on 100% ban rate for him or pick.
Yeah.
On this live stream. I don't know about the entire tournament. Yeah. That's something completely different. A man with three buttocks.
Of course.
This, however, is OD.
Yep. So OD is in this game. And I mean, we have seen a lot of Alchemist Visage and Darks here. These heroes are definitely trend. And for good reasons. All of them being really strong heroes. But OD making it in now. It's pretty much due to the very early Chen ban, I would say. And Lifesteal ban makes a little bit more sense, but banning out Chen that early against Na'Vi, Cinderin does not want any of that.
No. No, he does not, man. No, he does not. But what does Cinderin want?
Like, he wants a calm, calculated game.
That's, wow, that almost sounds like something I would have said.
Yes.
But yeah, he does. He does. It's the way Cinderin drafts, man. I'm actually, I have a little bit of inside information with these guys because they boot camped here.
Yeah.
They boot camped actually just downstairs. There's a room here in the building of our office building, which is Mousesports' room.
I saw it. There's a mouse logo on it and stuff.
Yeah, and our company actually used to be tied into Mousesports. We did a lot of work for them, and I believe we even owned the old owner of Freaks for You. The old Freaks for You, I believe, actually owned shares in Mousesports. I think he actually still does. He also works here in this office, hence probably the Mousesports room. So yeah, we actually have old ties to this company. But as far as Mousesports go, like, yeah, they were training here and they had like a big whiteboard down that room. And all it had listed was basically name a person, hero name. Heroes to focus on, new things to play.
Yeah.
That was what it all came down to. And, well, I'm not going to say Black had Alchemist on his list, because really, doesn't need to practice that one. But Fader, if I remember correctly, did have the OD on his list. I think also Koitva had the OD on his list. if I remember correctly. Some kind of like safe lane, like Clink's version of an OD. He's a play by Koipa, but he's got so many different things that he plays. Lone Druid's still on the pool for him as well, and that was also one of his favorite heroes.
Yeah. It's interesting. These players like Black and Koipa are kind of like sharing heroes in a funny way, making it very open for how Mouse want to draft in lane. But of course, another team that has pretty open drafts in lanes normally is Na'Vi. They're pretty rumored for being one of the teams that, you know, they just don't give a fuck. They kind of lane however they want and pick whatever they want. But
we saw it during the defense final when they did up against Kai. It's like, we're playing USE server. Let's just play whatever heroes we want to. Wait, everybody's dead? Success in life.
Exactly.
I just want to know how Na'Vi's going to handle that OD now. Because we've got Darkseer, Weaver, and Visage. Rubik comes up. So Cinderin gets one of his favorite heroes too. But support synergy here with Mousesports is really, really good. If it wasn't a Rubik pickup, I'd already be saying these guys would be going a Keeper of the Light. Again, I know, I call because I like it in all lanes. But with the Alchemist and the Rubik, if they even have one extra support hero with that one, we're looking at aggressive try lane. SD still available as well in the pool, but you've already kind of got the Rubik, so kind of don't need both of those. A follow-up damager, maybe even Lashrak, Alina could be combining it with this one. And then Na'Vi is like, what have they got? They need to have more lockdown to control the Weaver is the first thing that comes to mind.
Yeah.
And that could come through a lot of stuns, or it could just come through maybe even an older style hero that gets played a lot by Virtus Pro, just going to throw into the mix, not the Lone Druid, the Disruptor into the mix for Mousesports. Maybe not so much now that Lone Druid's in the pool.
Maybe not so much. Lone Druid kind of changes that.
Yeah.
And having Darkseer, Weaver, and Lone Druid, one of these heroes is going to go mid. Like,
The obvious one is Lone Druid.
Yeah.
Lone Druid will go up against the OD in the middle lane.
Yeah. It's a good mid hero against OD. Darkseer can do it because if you just double Iron Shell the first wave, then you run out in jungle, clear that, come back. So you can still choose, but Lone Druid is actually strong against OD mid. Of course, it's an even lane still, I feel.
The only problem you have is when OD gets into his later levels.
Yeah.
Then OD gets the upper hand. Then you just rotate the Lone Druid out around the 12-minute mark. He just leaves that middle lane, and you bring somebody else back in, and that's going to be your mid solo. But right now, like, it's going to force Denny to play at Lone Druid. Unless they give it to Havorst and they put Denny
hero at all, though.
No, it's a Havorst hero. It's like Havorst has to go middle lane with a Lone Druid up against the OD, and then Weaver goes the bottom lane. It's either that or Puppy takes up the Darkseer and goes jungle with that. And then we have Lone Druid in the middle, Weaver farming up in the bottom lane. He can go suicide top. It's only a Rubik right now, so the options are still open. And then they can give another hero for Denny to go bottom lane and be supported by Korra with Visage.
We'll see what Na'Vi decide to do, but what I really like so far in this draft is the fact that, you know, Lone Druid is a good counter to the OD on a lane because he lanes nicely against him, but I like even more the instant Rubik pick as soon as Weaver is picked. And I don't like when teams pick Weaver and the enemy has chance to pick up a support and Rubik is available, because it's so strong to have that Chikuchi on a Rubik. He can really make plays so easily. It's sort of imbalanced on him how you can chase after someone. And Ench now being added up by Mouse.
They're going bot, man. They are seriously going bot. Like, I was just describing right now what would happen if Na'Vi tried to stay inside their own jungle. You throw an Enchantress and a Rubik into the middle of all of that, and the possibility of a rotating Alchemist controlling that middle lane. Because the thing I'm looking for right now is what happens if that bear gets surged up and Iron Shelled up by a Darkseer at once got entangled up.
It can't get the Iron Shell anymore. The Spirit Bear. Reserve time. Since
don't remember that change.
It changed very long ago, I think. Didn't they change that?
You're the professional.
Yeah, I'm the pro. I don't know. I don't remember.
I believe you. I believe you.
It's a cheesy combo, but people used to do that a lot. Like, just send the offlane Darkseer and send the bear up on the lane. Then you just Iron Chill, and it's really, really annoying. I believe that it's changed. I can't remember, though, because no one really picked Darkseer and Lone Druid to lane together.
It's been a while. Yeah, I'm keeping my eyes on the chat as well to look for the words of wisdom from the community. Clockwork will be the last ban out here by Puppy. So he's still thinking the Koi for doesn't have his hero, and he's 100% right. Koi for doesn't. With this lineup, I'd still like to see the return of the Windrunner. Mm-hmm. I'd still like to see the return of the Windrunner. Cinderin hates me by banning out the Enigma in the last set.
He hates you. Well, to be honest, Enigma would have been really good for Na'Vi, but they pick Earthshaker instead. That's almost as fun, Tobi. That's almost as fun.
Yes, with the Earthshaker roll, DJ jump, that is just as much fun. And if you have an Enchantress who's building up an army of the dead, holy crap, you do not want to go into that at all. And if Alchemist even remotely considers, like we saw maybe early tonight with the Mana Style, ever considers that, yeah, life would be very, very difficult. But Mousesports will gain a lot of momentum with this lineup too. So let double creep waves, triple creep waves. Earthshaker, though, needs to find space to get that farm, but so does Visage. We're going to have two heroes here from Na'Vi that require a lot of money, which kind of does mean the Darkseer has to go the top lane, or it has to be Funic on that lone druid on the long. And you called it before, asking for the Broodmother? You joked about it.
I was joking, saying that Broodmother, we don't really see her at all. And then we see a Broodmother. But I want to point out something. We don't really see her at all, but the changes she has received as of pretty late, there are actually changes you should take note of. Like, the Incapacitating Bite is really, really strong. 60% miss chance and 40% slow is a lot. 60% miss is higher than it used to be, I believe. Mm-hmm. And then the fact that you spawn four spiders on max level is also really strong.
Yeah.
So I just don't know about picking her against this lineup with a Darkseer and an Earthshaker. It seems like a weird choice of a game.
Up against an Earthshaker, I can understand it. Because I have seen the power. I remember I was watching a game from, I think it was Lion's Pride, and it was Link who was taking up the role as the Broodmother. Yeah, and you had like these melee supports, like I think it was a Nyx Assassin, that tried to survive. And these spiders, because you spawn so many of them, getting these early surrounds before players are really ready for them, you can do it. You can lock people in position with these spiders, and then you just keep going. And this overall damage, and you can't stop it. Like, you're an Earthshaker. You want to throw a Fissure to get rid of spiders? No. Do you want a Totem Stomp? You might break a small gap open to get out of there, but that's going to be it. It's going to be very, very rough. On the upside, however, if Earthshaker does get his Blink Dagger and there is an army of Broodlings coming in,
Or if he just hits decent levels and Brood ever slacks on her micro and sends them pushing somewhere, or they get caught out in the jungle, that's so much gold and experience, because they give a lot of that as well.
Not to mention the damage, because it changed around, didn't it, with the Earthshaker ultimate?
Oh yeah, like the ulti gains damage from the spiders.
Yeah.
It does, but that's if you
It also works more differently with the illusions too, if I'm not mistaken.
I can't remember.
We'll not damage ethereal units. The initial damage will go through magic community. The additional damage will not. The units take an echo damage. Yeah, they modified it to make it even more stronger.
Initial damage going through magic community is new, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's quite interesting.
Mm. Wow, that's a lot of cheese bets for Na'Vi. Why did it say omelette de fromage?
Yeah, isn't that wrong? Isn't it supposed to be an E between the M, L, and L? I don't speak French, but just
I see
just
do.
Curious.
I see do and instantly think German, actually.
I don't know. I never studied French. I don't know this language.
I never studied Germany. I've lived here for 2 years. I've never done it.
You're horrible.
Oh, hello, Horvost. How much of a dick does he want to be? He comes up to plant down the sentry walls to stop Cinder from getting the bigger camps. And pass, he wants to stand his ground up against Horvost, and Horvost will run out of his Shikuchi and Puppy. Now he wants Fissure to go down. Havorst, he doesn't have Shikuchi back again. There's still a small gap to get through. And they harass pass down, but at the same time, like, they don't really achieve much, and it's pretty obvious the Sentry Ward has blocked the camp.
Yeah. I don't know about this, like, offlane Brood against a safe lane Darkseer, though. That's not a fun lane for Broods. Like,
It kind of turns Koitva into what could be just a straight DPS hero.
He could.
So if he goes up for that second level of of the Bite, up against Funic, then it could change around a little bit more. Level up the webs, you get your regeneration, you should be okay.
Exactly, you can do that. And it's actually quite effective. What I like to do when you go for that build is still having 1 point into the spiders, just to spawn them and deal that extra little poison damage, actually. You can do that, which is funny, because it deals a little bit more slow, a little bit more DPS as well with the poison that they deal.
And how's Fader looking up against Denny? Denny did actually end up taking up the lone druid. So we kind of actually haven't done that. It's our tradition here to run through the lane. So top lane matchups. I think at the same time, I want to keep my eyes a little bit closer on what's happening with Funnik, who for some reason is now behind the tier 1 tower. It's a creep skip with the damage to Koipa, who and now he finally levels up his next ability. He went for the Spineling. So it'll be Koipa on the Broodmother up against Funnik's Darkseer, then Dendi's lone druid in the middle lane up against Fader on the OD. And then up towards the top lane, we've got Havorst and Kuro on the Weaver as well as the Visage, respectively. They're going up against Black and Pass.
Puppy.
And
Puppy just stole the Enchantress Big Creep. Came in, one Fisher, got the Satire Hellcaller, killing it. That's so big. But you can't really stop it as well when Earthshaker comes in like that. Still a little bit sloppy by Syndrome to have it low enough HP for Puppy to kill it. Mm-hmm.
Man, these lanes are just so crazy. Puppy could actually die to Syndrome, or Syndrome could die to Puppy. No, that can't happen. Like, it's Enchantress with a heal up his sleeve. You don't have enough burst damage to kill off an Enchantress. But Puppy is definitely being a nuisance here inside the jungle.
Yeah, he's finding, you know, ways to be annoying.
You know, I think I've just realized the way the chat now cheers on from different people. Like, they just released the Wall of Kappa. I just saw a wall of Kappa come up here. I think there's more Kappa on this live stream than ever appeared on Sing Sing's.
I think that's highly unlikely.
Yeah, it's rather unlikely, but as I look at this chat right now, I'm pretty sure it's nothing but Kappa wall.
Yeah.
Probably shouldn't be encouraging by talking about it, but
you should probably not
cares?
Say that they can spam more Kappas than Sing Sing, because, well, that chat is, yeah. Anyway.
I love you, Twitch chat. I love you. I love you. Care of my moderators.
Please go back to the way you used to be.
What do you mean? What do you mean? They're fine. All right, let's look at our lanes, man, as far as CS goes. Because that middle lane is 12-5 up against a 9-6. This is the reason why Lone Druid works so nicely up against Fader. And it won't change. It won't change until Fader starts getting higher levels up in his orb. And then Denny's got to really protect his bear. But by that point, Puppy and Kuro should be the ones rotating. And Puppy, Fissure, Kuro, Grave Chill, Black is actually going to have a lot of help here. He goes to Concoction as well as Soul Assumption! Oh! It's enough!
That extra hit from Weaver.
He had the bugs on him and the Geminid attack followed him in back past the Tier 1 tower. And Na'Vi spill the first blood up against the Germans.
Na'Vi, their aggressive tri-lane paying off.
Only just though, man. Only just, like, that was a bee stick away from Black dying.
Yeah, but he did die. He did get first blooded, and you didn't miss it.
Yeah! Yeah. Still flawless.
Stun coming.
Yeah, Black wants it, man. He's right
behind
Puppy.
No, Puppy, what did he do?
Puppy locked himself in with a rock wall. Sat a blast, and that's his death.
And we see him just buying items. Like, yes, I'm an idiot. Yes, I'm buying items.
TP Stroll Clarity, I'm coming straight back anyway. You saw nothing.
He relied on you missing that one.
Hmm. You know what? This is still very negative, man. For my wonderful stats man who's doing the votes, I think it should be how many people think I will see First Blood. This is definitely a half glass empty look at First Blood. Needs to change around, peoples. Needs to change around.
Keep it this way.
Okay, give me the comp. Yeah, duly noted. Yeah, that's right. He listens to the cast, not the co-caster. I would say who pays his bills, but that's not me.
So, on this offlane, this Broodmother, she's behind the Darkseer farm, but so far she's doing okay.
Now she's got the three levels up in the... stop feeding spiders. With the three levels up in spiders, so maybe she can start taking control of the Radiant Jungle. Oh, Fader, dead in the middle.
She would need higher level on the webs to really get out there and use it, because she wants to have several webs on the lane as well, so maybe...
What if it's just the spiders, though? Like, you can still pull in the money even if you don't pull in the experience.
Yeah.
I know it's a bit of a trade-off, but... At the same time, having that money and denying it to anyone from Na'Vi that might rotate down there, that's good. Mousesports, they're going to try to have a crack here at top lane. That Dark Troll doesn't have a lot of life on it, but it's got enough for a Troll Trap, and they have the, Kuro's going to die here. Pick up Troll Trap, not the best synergy here from the lineup of Mousesports, and the Fissure from Puppy is going to split him up, and Kuro with the Grave Chill, movement speed, he doesn't have enough to get away. All he wants to do is slow down Black and give Havorst some space to attack, and he can't attack Black, so he just goes for the Enchantress, who's sprawking herself away, and does go down. Weaver will take it, double kill for Havorst, and he's going to get the Dark Trolls. Whoa, Havorst.
I am Superman.
No, that's supposed to be Dendy, man. He is Dendy the Superman.
Yes. It's really the power treads that gave him all those kills there, by the way. So quick attack speed, just kept attacking. And of course, the Gemini attack only makes it feel like you have even faster attack
speed. Phonic.
Getting bonus attacks.
So I don't know if you just saw that, but quite fast. He was really considering the surround, and then I think he just remembered there's a 4-level Iron Shell up on
yeah,
the Darkseer.
Yeah, you can't really surround Darkseer ever.
Mm-hmm. But he wants this tower. With the army he's got, it's semi-doable, and then all of a sudden, pulse, 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 and Spider's have to retreat.
He will never push the tower down here, and that's the sad part about that's the reason I felt that this lane is awkward. Oh,
pass.
The spiders don't
pass.
Oh.
Picking up Puppy, gonna throw him down. Cinder, and he's already got the troll trap, but now support. OD imprisons up, doesn't imprison the bear, takes out Denny, and OD drops the oldie. Ensures the kill on Puppy, but Cinder and Entangle should kill him off. Stick Charges didn't keep him alive long enough. So it's a one-for-one trade. The troll is still here. 6 seconds till he's got another trap, but he might have to use it too, because Fader dropping low once that bear starts attacking on him, and Fader will hold
Roof
him there, which means the troll trap is going to be here. He can't get one,
he
man.
Can't.
He
hit
can't get one to
times.
Save his life. And pass,
six.
First hit. Now, soul assumption on pass. They keep on going. Denny's got no mana left,
seven.
And this bear's about to die. Fissure flies through, and now a nice imprisonment. Saves himself from the damage. Denny does lose his bear. He doesn't have a resummon for 77 seconds as well.
Dendy, what is this? Seven attacks in a row and no entangle? Hasn't he watched enough Bulldog stream? He needs to learn how to click the entangle.
Hey, if I remember that correctly, Bulldog actually attacks you 8 times when you're running away with that Darkseer and you still didn't
I know
get
how
entangle.
To avoid entangles. It's
yeah,
a different skill.
Yeah, just scream out the words, Ice Frog! and then you're fine.
Yes. It's good.
So we blame Ice Frog for all the imbalances. Black, wow. Avoris just time-lapsed out the damage.
Yeah, Black is not having the game of his life here. 11 CS at 8 minutes in and 2 deaths to his name. He is struggling to say the least.
Come on, Black, you're in my fantasy team.
So, Avoris, keep killing him.
Actually,
go.
What do we got for that one? Fantasy points. I just realized I don't have a binder key for fantasy points. That's not too great. But whoever's got their fantasy points up, if you have Weaver, Lone Druid, or Darkseer, you're looking good right now. You're looking good. Phonic is winning you points here.
Oh, Phonic.
He's going to TP out very quickly. Safe. He even spent his money to pick up that Dyer's buckle before he went out. Tower is under attack. Hey, I just realized, man. I have Dendy in my fantasy team. Booyakacha, 2.5 points.
He can't root.
That's true, but he still gets 2.5 points without rooting. Yeah, level of Dendy increased. All right, so 6-3 on the board. Fader with a regeneration rune up his bottle now. He'll be very, very happy with that. He's got that first one up into orb. Actually, also known as two Fader, he rushed his orb point. Like, normally you see that third point in the Essence Aura for Fader's normal build before he'll start going up in the Arcane Orbs.
Yeah.
But he's already he wants that one extra point in the orb. And now, help, Black coming in, concoction. This is going to be really, really bad for Denny. That is a long stun time. Fader, he doesn't have ulti available. He's got past telekinesis, pick him up, throw him back, and now Denny will go down.
Yeah, and that's why we see him have this point in orb so early. Your DPS is a lot better. And sure, you risk going out of mana, but with a regen rune in his bottle, he's perfectly fine.
Yep. Radiant's middle tower. He's also now got the other great thing from that. Denny doesn't have a resummon on his bear for 60 seconds, and he respawns in 12. That's
rough.
Yeah.
That's rough. But even worse is this Alchemist on the top lane. Now, Black has to go back and try and lane against Havorst again, but Havorst is so strong that he's probably just going to dive.
Yep.
He's baiting it,
but
though.
But by diving it, Sada's going to come in through the side, actually gets to hit on the blast, but it forces Havorst a little bit further back, and he even uses his time-lapse for that.
Yeah.
He's really not taking any kind of risk here. Quite far. Man, I wonder how many spiders he's actually fed in this bottom lane.
I saw him die with 10 right as the engagement was mid.
Oh, Funnick, if he vacs this.
Yeah, that's the thing. He can always vac, and, you know, already there, that was like 7 spiders, and it's a lot of gold.
Yep.
It's like killing 3 lane creeps, killing 7 spiders-ish.
It's good moolah, man. It's good moolah. And now he's going to get more.
All the time, just trying to find that money.
Yeah, he's definitely getting it, man.
Okay, shake.
Only 7 games on record.
Wow.
That's a really good win rate.
That's a damn good win rate, but of course, having only 7 games with it is not really reliable stats, I would say, but still, that's impressive.
That's a very impressive stat. Fader, there's your first hit entangle. Denny even backed himself up thinking he wasn't going to get it, but he moves around to body block him up.
This timing by Puppy.
Yeah, Fissure actually bumps him away and doesn't do the stun. Black TPs himself in with a pretty well channeled up concoction, and now they'll lose Puppy and move deeper. Looking over to both Rubik as well as Denny, but Kurin was turned around. They've got a bear trapped up here. They've got to get this bear back out to safety. There is no resummon for Dendy for 81 seconds. And Avorst, he's here in the middle lane.
Here.
Yeah, welcome him. Pick up, throw him down. He stuns the bear as well as Denny and Kuro. And then Black will throw the stun, but Avorst, well, he'll actually get hit by that.
Yeah, it hits Invis, and it hits also hits if you rage. You still take damage as it's physical. Yeah.
But you won't take the stun if you've got the immunity.
If you're Invis, you still get stunned, though. That's interesting to note.
I think actually he wore off. Like the Shikuchi wore off, I think.
Yeah, but even if you are Invis, you will get stunned.
Okay. Man, so Funic, how much money has he got? It's so stupid. He's 109 CS. Weaver has 71 for 30. Avorst, who's basically been controlling up this top lane, has 71 for 30. He has the highest net worth. It's just because all of those CS, which is coming the way of Darks here, so much of it is just spidling. But there's 5.5k net worth going the way of Avorst. And now they rotate up with Dendy, and they look to take out towers now.
Yeah, pushing tower. I mean, this is what you want to do when you have a bear in your team. You just go together pretty early on and start training. Because OD can't really react. He can't TP up their top. He doesn't have full step, doesn't have mech, but he is pushing mid. And this tower will actually go down as well if no one does anything. Mm-hmm. And it's the Hellbears saying hi.
Cinderin is always present on the map. Even if he's dying, he's still present. And he will help to kill off the tower. In fact, he's just killed off by the dire side normally.
Oh, so many spiders dying to Funic.
They're ganking bottom lane. Concoction's prepping up, and Funic, well, there's already that first hit, and now Concoction will hit at the same time he surged. The mech charge will pop here, but they get the spiders around him, trying to hold him in position, but the Iron Shell damage is still a lot. He throws down the wall. He's trying to kill off quite, but Funic, living life to the edge. Yeah. Black will run out of here, though.
Trying all he can, but...
He gave it a shot.
He gave it a good try, but... The push is top still, and Puppy almost up to money for his mana boots now. Getting some last hits here on the creeps.
How's Pass doing? He's the one. The one to hold. Centaur's coming in, Cinderin.
Well, he has Shikuchi, so he's perfectly fine. He's gonna hold up here top quite easily.
What, look, he actually stopped. Oh, nicely.
That is very nice.
T1 tower for Mousesports. Army of Spiders, Centaur in tow.
Brood almost has Orchid now.
Yeah.
And at that point, then she can...
TPs.
Well,
I don't know if this is really a wise thing from Avorst, but then again, it's Avorst, so who cares? He's going for Cinderin. And he'll get the kill. Cinderin doesn't have enough mana for a heal. One charges, two of them. Now we can heal, but it's already too much damage done by Avorst, or is it? It isn't enough.
The heal
Fader
is
in
strong.
Here as well. But the bear, Denny has to get closer. He can't get the entangle, and you're right, he is trying to block it up, but now he'll just take the tower instead. Consolation prize, free box of chocolates for Dendy.
Yep.
And the set of steak knives to come on the next tower.
A set of steak knives. And look at Puppy just standing here, guarding top.
I actually want to keep my eye on Koitva. Pass is coming in to actually go on Kuro. Kuro, a little bit too far out. Pick up, throw it down. Pass, that's another steal if he wants it.
Black
and now Fissure, it's going to hurt. You're right, Black is here. And so is Puppy. Echo Slam hits pretty hard. And Black, it's a good thing it's inside that chemical rage. But now it's a bad thing. Puppy, he's body blocking Black. And then follows up the totem stomp. Black, he's
got
22. They got him. The Soul Assumption will take it.
Oh, wow.
What an Echo Slam. What a, they held him there just long enough for the second Soul Assumption.
Yeah. It's the chain stun, the body block, nice play by Puppy. And that's why I said, so nice by him to just stand there and let Kuroki bait. And it's pretty obvious bait, to be honest, Kuroki being that far out.
Yeah.
But even so, they thought they could kill him. But Visage, pretty tanky hero, pretty hard to kill when you have a ES throw that extra Fissure in.
Mm-hmm. So how fast, too, that Rubik just bailed out Koitva. Man, what did he actually give to have that Orchid on him? In fact, he can buy the Orchid and hasn't. He's been able to buy that Orchid for the last, I think, almost minute now.
Yeah, that's...
And the Courier's just sitting AFK back at base, not doing anything. That's... Is this intentional, or is this...
No, that's a bit sloppy. Now he bought it, and nothing else, so he wasn't saving up to buy more.
Too busy in the micro.
Yeah.
Sentry wall goes down, back doesn't reach him. And now there's a steal. Pass takes Shikuchi. They still got that sentry wall, but Havoc picked up, throwing down. He needs this Orchid right now, and now he's got it. Maybe Orchid up on Havoc. He's going to go Insatiable Hunger. No, Havoc says, well, I now have BKB. I trump your Orchid, and now kill your Rubick. And if he can. The dust, Rubick, pass. Is it enough? No, that's all. Something charge was too weak.
Very close with the dust coming in from the side there. Almost got him.
So it'll be a tier 2 tower loss in the bottom lane. Yeah, I don't really see him stopping this. Well, they can't finish off that tower, though. Yeah. Syndrome doesn't have push.
Yeah, Dendi pulled the aggro on the top lane, so he can just farm. And now the TP's coming bottom.
Pass has to be really careful. He already has to back up. That Fissure from Puppy managed to connect OT Halty. They try to combine it up with the Orchid from Quaffer, and the charge is not enough.
Not enough.
Not the Spider Links.
Even at that.
Pass wanted to go back in again. Now he's finally TPing himself back to base to heal.
Am I the only one who feels it's a little bit awkward seeing Dendi just being the solo pusher, like split pushing, not fighting?
It does feel a little unnatural, doesn't it?
Yeah.
But it's the draft that they were forced into. There are no games on record. Okay? The first game ever that Dendi plays at Lone Druid. But look at his build for it. Like, he's got phase boots up on one. He's got tranquil boots. This is almost classic Fear. This is EG Fear build.
Oh, it's pretty normal build, to be honest, to have tranquils and phase boots.
I'm just saying, when Dota 2 first saw the appearance of Lone Druid,
yes,
Fear was the one that did this build.
Yeah.
And then Aoi copied it and then enhanced it with an armlet.
Well, the old tranquil boots were so OP that people used them on pretty much every hero. And now it's not as good. And it's a good thing that he's not fighting, because tranquils are absolute shit if you fight. No, they are. Like, they turn into these broken 25 movement speed boots, which are basically half as good as brown boots. So, yeah, they're really bad.
Denny's about to get trapped out here. Well, maybe trapped. There's a troll right behind him looking to trap him. Denny, he's got ulti-form possibilities. He's trying to juke it. Oh, wow, Dendi. Pass wants to fight him. Chikuchi. He saw him, but too late. And Pass just hides his head in shame.
He's like, oh, damn it.
Well, Fader did.
Yeah. Fader. That was kind of funny, though. Oh. Pass was simply too fast. He just ran by it.
It's like Astral, that spot. Damn, I'm in that spot. Okay. Havoc. He's put his BKB again. He's really not giving up on this BKB. He's got Sentry Wars, too. And Koifa doesn't quite see it. And, well, he's out of his invis. Throws the Orc at Havoc, though. He can't time lapse, or can he? No, actually, Orchid wasn't you.
No, he just had CD.
Oh, okay. Pass trying to chase Havoc. Chikuchi versus Chikuchi. The same time Enchantress dying on the top lane. It's like Kuro able to find himself a kill.
Yeah, they were trying to take this tier 1 top. And it's still not deniable. So, nice hold.
Pass. Entangle. Doesn't hit on the first one. Orb of Venom does slow him down, though.
Dendi trying to work on that mid tower would be a nice pick off.
Well, Fader would love the bear instead. This is that damage of the orb. It's still only a 1-level orb for this OD.
But it doesn't hit very hard on the bear because it doesn't count as a real summon like the treants. So you still only get the mana pool damage from it. Else you would slay the bear in like 4 hits or something later on.
Black might be in trouble. Koro, familiars in front. Guess 1-2, drop down, almost backed him back up on top of the hill, but Black away. Yeah. Inside that Chemical Rage, it'll be the worst time for Dias. He's trying to prep himself into that Shadow Blade.
He probably tried to back him to the other side of the hill, which would be really nice, but Dias backing onto that part of the hill is not possible. To the right side, you can, but not right there.
Notice the movement of Black. Instantly you realize that Na'Vi have so much force up on that top lane, they cannot defend the tier 2 tower, so he pushes out the mid. While Broodmother continues to hold inside the Radiant Jungle and add as much pressure to that tier 2 tower in the bottom lane as possible. This is a trade of almost of entire jungles. Na'Vi will claim Dire side jungle, while Mousesports will claim Radiant side jungle.
Yeah, it looks kind of funny when you look at it. And almost Shadowblade completed now on Black. He only needs to last these two creeps, and he has it. So, finished up.
Which means now Initiation can come.
Thank you.
Ishkafel?
I guess. Ishkafel?
Ishkafel.
Yeah, it sounds German, to be honest.
When
you
Nine!
When you pronounce it.
Nine!
Probably isn't supposed to sound German.
Ishkafel?
Ishkaufen.
Kaufland. Ah.
Yes. So Roshan.
Way to just butcher German words.
Roshan still not being attempted by the team, but with the tier 2 tops removed now by Na'Vi, I really expect them to put a lot of pressure to this mid now. If they can get the mid tier 1, then they will start thinking about Roche.
They gotta be careful, because OD's walking around with a DD rune up his sleeve.
And he hits hard already as is.
Yeah. So they gotta make sure they keep their distance. If they commit heroes to push out that tier 1 tower in mid, like Blyze continuously, ooh, missing a last hit. He's sorry. I troll. He's getting his own farm here. Pass still finding his own levels. Na'Vi aren't really gaining a huge advantage until they take out the T1 tower, but doing exactly that will help him out. So Fissure into a Vag, into a Grave Chill, pass with still one charge up his sleeve, is able to live.
Yeah, Kroki cancelling his soul assumption there because he knows that it wouldn't be enough.
Are they looking to fight this? Syndrome's coming in, and Fader has returned to the middle lane now.
Yes, TP bottom. We might see a kill here.
It depends. Avorce is just having fun with Spidlings right now, and then Sentry, they see him. Fissure, and then attack, ulti. Attack, and then in he goes. He goes in for the Insatiable Hunger with the Orchid on Puppy, so he couldn't get the secondary hit, and Koipa does get the kill, limping himself back into the Spidling web and away from Dendi, and he goes
he up,
and they are checking. Kuro, he tried to go with a Familiar Stomps, he missed the target. The Meg Charge helps out the orb.
Root.
Another web has to go. He can't root shot anything. And Avorce will, well, he has to back up, but no, the Spidlings. They've almost got him trapped in, and then Chikuchi for the win.
He can't get trapped. But Puppy, what are you doing? He was waiting very long after his Fissure, trying to get the maximum stun duration before he throws his next stun.
Uh-huh.
And of course that's a good thing and good habit to always try and get the maximum out of it, but he would have killed him with just an enchant totem without even having the max duration. So instead of killing, gave a kill towards the Broodmother and she actually lived. So that delays his Blink Dagger. If that was a kill, he would be so close to it now, like just 1k. Just 1k more gold.
That's if he's allowed to get that money. Because what's Kuro supposed to be getting too? Like Kuro's walking around with boots and a gem. Summary of items on Kuro.
Boots, gem. He has a magic
blink
wand, bro.
In. Blink in on Funic.
That's a supporter's best friend. Magic wand.
Suppose.
Just wait till we have the blink on ES as well, and then blink on Darkseer. The initiations they can do, man.
Cinder and Bear, he won't be able to get a hit off. Denny's getting closer, but he's still just too far away. Fader. Man, he has been on level 11 for such a long time. He spent most of his time just basically flying himself from the middle lane to the bottom lane.
Broodmother is actually doing really fine this game, though. Like, I guess it's expected that she should be doing. Oh, look at that.
Money.
Yeah,
money,
that's
money,
the thing.
Money,
she's
money,
doing
money,
sort
money,
of
money,
fine,
money,
but
money,
she's
money.
Giving so much more to Funic as well. Like, he could just come down here to his ATM machine and just say, yo, can you give me this and this? I need to get, like, a plate mail for the Shiva's thing.
I need a loan with no repayments.
Exactly.
Thank you.
And the Broodmother always pays. Not saying she's a Lannister.
Radiant structures. That's only she's fortified. Got a debt.
Yeah, I guess she does. But point booster is up. Point booster is up on the visage, so he does have one item now. We don't have to feel sorry for him. Running around with magic wand and gem alone, and Demon Edge purchased on the Weaver, who already had a javelin. So he goes for one javelin into a Demon Edge into another javelin.
That's a lot of smokes. Well, I say a lot of smoke. One smoke with a lot of people smoked up in it, and they're going to find Pass, or where they won't. He's in Chikuchi.
Well, Pass is kind of hard to kill.
Yeah, and Funic blinks up, backs him in again, but it's just like, where is he? Fissure, it's going to hit.
Wow.
The Fissure attack, and they got him. You're right. Up to the hill, and that gem from Kuro just gave him the vision. He must have been sitting right on the edge of the range of that gem.
Yeah, they had an uphill ward, so they saw that he was there, and then Kuro just, you know, he flapped his wing as fast as he could. Got close enough for the gem vision. Gem vision is a lot better than sentry vision. Should be mentioned. I don't remember exactly how long it is, but it's quite long.
Got a little bit of fun now for Na'Vi as they attack on the tier 2 tower in the middle lane. It won't take much longer to bring this down.
Yeah, meanwhile top tier 1 went down. That tier 1 was alive for so long, but now going the way of Black. Black almost has a BKB along with his Shadowblade, so he has started farming. not finished.
Was funny picking up. Sell something. We're looking at
He wants the Mystic Staff, but he doesn't want to sell his magic wand.
They can always just kill off Roshan.
Yeah, it's not always that easy, Tobi.
Life is meant to be that easy. Poppy has Blink Dagger. He just hit 2260. A little bit more than what he needed, but when he fishes an entire creep wave on top lane, money, money, money.
Money, money, money. Yeah, so double Blink now available, of course, the Darkseer and the ES. So if any form of 5-on-5 fight happen, and they're not careful to BKB early on the Brood, for example, stuff can go really bad. But they have BKB on both Brood and Alchemist now, so I wouldn't worry too Radiant's much for them. Top
tower is well, attack. Again, we're in that position where Quaver has the money, but he hasn't purchased the item. 2,400 gold on him, and he hasn't bought up the BKB, and now he does. He has buyback available too now. Maybe that was his deterring factor.
Maybe. I don't know. I don't think it's crucial for a Brood to have buyback at this stage of the game, though. It's
You buy back and what do you bring to the fight?
That's the thing. If you die and like you buy back without BKB, compared to just having the BKB from the start, is no. He's just buying a little bit slow, but maybe there's a lot of talk or something.
You could just see it's all again. Money, 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 money.
It's crazy how much
it gets.
It's like.
He had a 9 shell on Havorst as well, and Havorst was Shikuchi-ing through.
And he has the gem now, by the way.
Oh, Puppy. Blinked up. He found Koifa. He even throws the Echo Slam for this one, and Koifa.
This time, that's payback time for the time they did not throw his stun in time. Puppy is like, yeah, okay, I'm fucking stunning you. It's time. It's hammer time. And he just throws down all the stuns.
And this is now Na'Vi's Roshan.
Yeah, with MKB on Weaver, this should be an easy Rosh.
Very, very quick.
It goes really fast is what I mean. Of course, it's an easy Rosh when the enemy team is not contesting.
Mouse is just looking for the best counters they can get, but like they want to push out top lane. Poppy's already gone back for that one. There's an extra TP. In fact, double TP is coming in. So Weaver takes the Aegis and then Blink up, back in again. And Funnik, it looks like he's trying to surge in front so he can body block it, but the amount of damage he's taking, almost not worth it. But the amount of time he bought for Poppy to Blink himself in and get that hit. Even the dust being popped off. Dendi, he needs
on,
an entangle.
Dendi.
Can't get it. Two
you
hits.
You have Basher
Third
and entangle. Do
working.
Something.
Fourth hit.
Dendi.
Can't get anything.
Do it.
Fifth hit.
Fucking
can't get
it.
Anything. And now Black goes Invis. Fissure. That's one way to hit him. Familiar Stomp. Familiar Stomp. He'll come out of Shadow Blade. They've gone east, but Black's gone west.
I think I know why Dendi never played Lone Druid. What is this? He has Basher and entangle. Like. Okay.
Some days you just can't win, man.
I guess Dendi is not an RNG gamer.
I just think Ice Frog is trying to like, this is like a handicap for Dendi.
Yeah.
It's like, sorry, Dendi, like you're coming into this with a plus 9.
If Dendi holds the alt button over his Basher and over his Entangle, he will see the true numbers for his chances. It's a lot lower.
The only thing is this. Well, you got a chance of this percentage, and really all the numbers just replaced with Ice Frog. And that's it. Your chance is now Ice Frog.
Sometimes you can Ice Frog. Sometimes you don't. Yeah.
I
don't know. That was
always Ice Frog, man. You can't always Ice Frog.
That was seriously unlucky, though. Like,
he got it on the creep in the middle, so obviously...
Yeah, he gets it on the creeps all the time. He permabashed Roshan. Like, he's Slayer of Creeps. But he doesn't get it at all the heroes.
Maybe that's it. The Spirit Bear, his Entangle is now turned into like the Droid Ranger old ulti. Like the 33% chance
the
to kill off a creep instantly.
Yeah.
Yeah. The new thing, Entangle being replaced.
Oh, they're going in a little bit
Funnik
aggressive.
Back,
oh, they
as pulled,
him, pulled
him to the other side of the fissure and into the wall. Visage will get the kill.
Beautiful combo.
And now they
the wall was
the
a little bit overkill though.
Oh, nice stun by Black. Actually catching up both Funnik as well as Denny. There's a lot of damage with the Impetus. Not to mention the Spylings as well. And the Voss, BKB, he just chases down the captain. He kills off Cinderin and now looks for another target. Sim will buy back into this one. There's just BKBs galore from both Black as well as Koifa. And they're trying to force him back out. Kuro and this bear is not healthy. And Black, you're right, the bash was there. But now Black, concoction.
And look, now he's actually doing it. Bashing and tagging alike.
Echo Slam, Familiar Stun, Koifa's Invis. He throws out one last of Spylings and he'll buy back. But this is going to be mid-rax. They still continue to fight throughout the wall.
Yeah. The wall is dangerous to fight nearby.
Orchid on Bear. I think they wanted the concoction as well.
He failed stunning himself instead. That was nice for Na'Vi. Like, they don't need to do anything more than that. They got a lot of experience from that fight. Definitely coming out on top. And they will have a assault cuirass now, finished up on Dendi. So he's looking pretty strong. And what does Weaver actually have? He has 3.3k gold. Hasn't really decided what to buy yet.
He'll make up his mind once he sees what Mousesports want to do. And then he'll dress to match.
Yes, and a full Shiva.
Or he'll just say, screw it, just buy it all up right now.
Yeah, he bought a Messerschmitt, or a Reaver, that is. And of course, full Shivas now on the Darkseer, making him really tanky as well.
And agging himself to Fakuro.
Oh, yeah.
The only downside is he can't resummon for 96 seconds now.
That's one of those sad parts where he's like, yeah, your ulti is now better in 2 minutes.
You may as well just lost the entire thing on a courier that just died.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, Avorce finds Koyev.
Oh, the MKB!
Koyev instantly backs out.
Wow. Okay. He hit him like 4 times. 35% chance. Nope.
The chances aren't with Na'Vi today, man.
Na'Vi are playing against the RNG gods. And they're winning.
Makes no sense.
Yeah.
You can't go against the RNG gods. Maybe the sacrifice wasn't
Maybe
made.
That's what happened in the Fnatic games as well. Like,
I don't know, man. I don't know. We didn't watch the Fnatic games. We'll have to wait until after tonight to check those one out. Fader, top lane. Well, looks like he was trying to TP out. Now Basher and Entangle. Dendi has finally managed to break off the chances of Funnic. In he goes with the Shiva's Guard and the Familiar's drop down too.
Really nice kill. Just coming in with the Shivas to secure it.
Black, almost dead. Actually is dead. Gentleman attack from Avorce. He's man fighting. It's
yeah,
one on three.
He's
taken one. He's now going to go take Cinderin out. And now Aegis. Well, it will trigger.
And he can kill the last one as well. Like, he can kill the Brute.
Let's see. Koyva. He's going to hit pretty hard then.
He's not going to dive. But
it doesn't matter because the mid lane's already been taken. Puppy is in here with Koro. Fortification has to come up. But with Mousesports with 4 heroes on the sideline, it's looking almost impossible for them to defend this. Not to mention the top lane's just pushed in too with Dendi, solo split push, taking out top racks.
Yeah, solo split push.
Then GG.
GG.
GG is the call from Mousesports. They say this is over. Black is the man to call it.
And this was a strong game by Na'Vi. There was no chance for Mouse.
Yeah.
Like, there was no opening.
We'll have to see if they can find one in game number two, man, because that is going to be where the telling time is. Because really, you're one game down now. Mousesports, I believe their record in the tournament now goes 1-2.
1-2.
If I'm not mistaken.
Yes,
and Na'Vi, actually,
correct.
Exactly the same.
1-2.
They're both 1-2. So Na'Vi and Mousesports hold the...
So one of them is going to be 1-3 very soon.
Very, very soon. Very, very soon. Of course, we'll be back here in a little bit too, guys. So stay tuned. We'll see you guys shortly for our game number 2. Mousesports coming up against Na'Vi.